Well, welcome this morning. Good to see everyone here. We're still missing a few people. I don't know if headmans are coming or not, but we'll go ahead and start. We have the three announcements that have been happening each week. Men's Saturday morning, 7 a.m. prayer meeting here at the church, and English Sunday worship at 10:30 for the next few weeks. We aren't planning any changes to that, so you can come at this time. And then women's Bible study. The women are having a good time on Wednesday at 1 p.m. on Zoom. So if you can find the link to that on jschurch.church and join that. I think it's the same link that you're using, isn't it, Michelle? I need to get you the password and username so you could create an ongoing one so that it's right there for anybody to join and wait for you until it'd be easy to give it to you. And then you don't have to stop at 40 minutes, which would be nice. So any other announcements, Brian, that you're aware of? We have a good worship prepared for you this morning. We're moving on into chapter 4 of Philippians. Okay, we'll let Brian come forward and lead us in prayer.
Okay, and we'll just bow our hearts in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we just thank you and praise you this morning. Lord, we have this opportunity to come together and worship you. Lord, on the Most High. And Lord, we just thank you for, you know, the music that we've been able to practice and the preparations and all the time that Jim puts in on the sermon. Lord, we just thank you that you have just laid out the pathways for us, and just and we can hear and see how the body of Christ working together actually works. And Lord, we do pray for Kevin Byes, Lord, and we just pray that give the doctor's wisdom or whatever path that you want to take with his life, Lord. Lord, we do pray for his heart and, you know, his spiritual situation, Lord, that he would know you, and Lord, as he has made proclamations of faith to you, Lord, we just wish that he would join us in the body in some way, in a tangible way, Lord. Lord, and we would just pray that he would wake up knowing that you have a purpose for his life. Lord, that's just our prayer for him. Lord, we also pray for Dale Henry, as he has been, you know, following you for, you know, in this missionary service in Uzbekistan for years and years and years, Lord, and it's just time for him for to do something else, Lord. I just would pray that you would make that abundantly clear, Lord, and yeah, you can continue to use he and Jean in spreading your gospel, spreading your word, and caring for people, Lord, as they have done so many years. And just thank you for their service to you. And Lord, we also pray for the people that are going to be coming in and trying to fill those shoes behind them, Lord, that they would that you would guide their paths and be able to have all the pieces fit into place where the ministry can continue in such a challenging area as Uzbekistan and Tashkent, where you never know when, you know, if the authorities are going to knock on your door and shut you down or worse. And Lord, we do, thank you that the COVID has been declining, Lord, and we're able to release some of the requirements. But Lord, we just thank you for, especially your watch care over this congregation, and we've had no outbreaks within the Hispanic or our congregation. We just thank you for that, and we just pray that there would be an end to this. But Lord, even more so, we would just pray that people would learn to rely on you in any circumstance in this world. That if they're depending on this world, they're depending on the wrong thing. That you can carry us through, COVID or a motorcycle accident or, financial difficulties. You can carry us through all of those things, Lord, and we can lean on you confidently for all of our wants and needs. And Lord, we just thank you that we can be together and share in you in all of this. And we do thank you for Jim's preparations, and we pray that we would hear your words through him this morning. These things we lift up in Jesus' name. Amen.
Our call to worship this morning is from Psalm 145, verses 1-13. I will extol you, O God, my God and King. Bless your name forever and ever. Every day I will bless you and praise your name forever and ever. God is great and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. One generation shall commend your works to another and shall declare your mighty acts. On the glorious splendor of your majesty and on your wondrous works, I will meditate. They shall speak of the might of your awesome deeds, and I will declare your greatness. They shall pour forth the fame of your abundant goodness and shall sing aloud of your righteousness. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. The Lord is good to all, and his mercy is over all that he has made. All your works shall give thanks to you, O Lord, and all your saints shall bless you. They shall speak of the glory of your kingdom and tell of your power, to make known to the children of man your mighty deeds and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and your dominion endures throughout all generations. Debbie's going to come forward and lead us in our worship this morning, and as we join together in praise and thanksgiving to the Lord.
If you'd stand with me now, and we're going to sing "To God Be the Glory." Since we have the same spirit of faith according to what has been written, I believed and so I spoke. We also believe, and so we also speak, knowing that he who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and bring us with you into his presence. For it is all for your sake, so that as grace extends to more and more people, it may increase thanksgiving to the glory of God.
Who ye?
The next song we're going to sing is I Love You, Lord. And 1 John 4:20-21 says, if anyone says, I love God and hates his brother, he is a liar. For he who does not love his brother, whom he has seen, cannot love God, who he has not seen. In this commandment we have from him, whoever loves God must also love his brother. Song we're going to sing is How Can I Keep From Singing? Philippians 4:4 says, rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice.
My storm can shake my inmost calm.
next song is As the Deer Pants for Water. Psalm 42, 1-2 says, As a deer pants for flowing streams, so pants my soul for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? Song is Teach Me Thy Way, O Lord, and in Psalm 86, 1-11, we read, Incline your ear, O Lord, and answer me, for I am poor and needy. Preserve my life, for I am godly. Save your servant who trusts in you, you are my God. Be gracious to me, O Lord, for to you do I cry all day. Gladden the soul of your servant, for to you, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. For you, O Lord, are good and forgiving, abounding in steadfast love to all who call upon you. Give ear, O Lord, to my prayer. Listen to my plea for grace. In the day of my trouble, I call upon you for your answer, for you answer me. There is none like you among the gods, O Lord, nor are there any works like yours. All the nations you have made shall call and worship before you, O Lord, and shall glorify your name. For you are great and do wondrous things. You alone are God. Teach me your way, O Lord, that I may walk in your truth. Unite my heart to fear your name.
Teach me thy way, O Lord. Teach now to him who is able to do far more abundantly than all that we ask or think, according to the power at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord bless you, make his face shine upon you, and give you peace. Go with you this morning as you go out into the world. We thank you. Thanks in Jesus' name. God bless you. Amen.